Second Chronicles chapter 9 verse 1 is the biblical passage which dwells on the story of Queen Sheba's brave and daring nature. The Queen of Sheba is also a figure first mentioned in the Hebrew Bible. According to Jewish and Islamic traditions, Queen of Sheba or Bilikisu, as referred to in Arabic, flourished in the 10th century. In the biblical account, during the reign of King Solomon, she visited his court riding on a camel caravan bearing gold, jewels, and spices. The story provides evidence for the existing commercial relationships between ancient Israel and southern Arabia. The purpose of her visit was to test Solomon's wisdom by asking him to solve a number of riddles. As documented in the Holy Quran, Queen Sheba was referred to as Bilikisu, and her sojourn was also of similar narratives to that of biblical account, where a visit to Prophet Sulaiman was also mentioned. Bilikisu and her kingdom was said to have been the worshipper of sun before her encounter with King Solomon, who in his wisdom, having successfully solved the riddles, she did however become a believer of new faith. According to historical accounts, Bilikisu was a wealthy woman and a leader of a group of women porters who travels far and wide.
Kabesa wo jale akile jebu uko luda alase package osha ajogun
baba here in Okeri under Ijebu Ode local government area in Ogun State lies a sacred place believed to be the burial place of the biblical Queen of Sheba, and abode has become a mecca of sorts for many who are familiar with the historical narrative. Named Bilikisu Sungbo Shrine, the location is somehow turned to a place of worship, which has remained a tourist site to both local and foreign visitors who would like to share the mysteries surrounding the shrine.
People visit annually for prayers.
Once in a year.
Arguments abound when the need to give account of any historic event arises, as no one has the monopoly of knowledge as to what has happened. However, the tourist site is embedded with rich socio-cultural values.
It was gathered that Bilikisu Sungbo disappeared into the ground. Many of the followers were gathered to have turned to water.
Queen Sheba was said to have traveled from Ethiopia to a location now known as Okeri in Ijebu Ode, where she died, and this accounts for why the natives of Ijebu Ode have since held a strong claims about the identity of Bilikisu Sungbo, and the shrine has forever remained the pride of the Ijebu people as a tourist destination site full of historical facts. Queen Sheba was believed to possess supernatural powers, evident in ditches dug around her grave and other parts of Okeri. It was also revealed that since she was buried, the entire graveyard has remained grassless and very neat.
Oh, yeah,
Before the partially decent roofing was made by bamboo shrubs, the graveside was covered by webs.
Just like we get a wallet, if you are randy, so kumbe, you are looking. Book born, not a map, but even about to call that this is what you could get a day that could be 60 seconds a day before I go. On my way, walk over by. If we talk about Jabba Sile,
since our disappearance into the ground, the grass site has become a site to be old, as no grass can ever grow on the spot when she was buried.
Women and dogs are forbidden from entering into the burial spot of Queen Sheba, and this, according to research, was as a result of what transpired between the queen and the people while on a visit to the place. She was said to have been disappointed by the women who were supposed to welcome her, thereby forbidding them never to set their eyes on her again. In 1995, Bilikisu Sungbo Shrine was added into the culture category of the UNESCO World Heritage Site. Bilikisu Sungbo is a long-abandoned tourist site, which is obviously calling for attention from government at all levels, as the entire place was dotted by relics, with sounds of birds already taking over the place.